Google Fonts offer a massive library of high-quality fonts you can use for free on your websites as system fonts or within design tools like Canva and Google Docs. First, go to Google Fonts website at fonts.google.com. This is an ever-growing collection that as of June 2024 had 1,643 fonts. When you get to the page, you can scroll through the fonts and see a preview of each. Click on the arrow in the bottom right corner to return to the top. On the right, you can change how you view the fonts, either see them in a grid or in rows. You can sort the font list by trending, most popular, newest, or in alphabetical order. The most popular fonts category displays fonts that have consistently high download numbers or analytics data according to Google Fonts. This helps, but can still feel very overwhelming finding fonts you like. After scrolling for a while, they all seem to look alike. So a better way to find fonts you like is by selecting the filter option in the top left. This displays a sidebar with different filtering options for the font results. You can include your own preview text or you can use the standard pengrams, which use all the letters of alphabet in testing text. Then you can adjust the font size. You can narrow down the number of fonts displayed with additional criteria. First, I'm going to specify the language to only include fonts with relevant alphabets. That got us down to 1,625 fonts. Under technology, you will see a new type of fonts, variable. Variable fonts are single font files that act like a library, letting you adjust weight, width, and other styles on the fly. With this criteria, I would get down to 373 fonts, so I won't use it right now. To narrow down our list further, you can specify the type of fonts, serif, slab serif, or sans serif. In a nutshell, serif fonts have decorative lines at the end of the characters. Slab serifs are like blocky serifs, and sans serif fonts, which I will select, are fonts that have clean modern appearance and are without decorative lines. That got us down to 773 fonts. Under classification, display fonts are designed for large headings or titles. Handwriting fonts mimic the appearance of human handwriting. And monospace fonts characters occupy the same amount of horizontal space. I will select handwriting fonts, which got us down to 12 fonts. If one of the criteria narrows the list of fonts too much, you can expand it by either changing or removing this or previously selected filters. Under properties, you can specify the size of the font library, meaning whether you get different line weights, italic, bold, etc. styles for the font. Nowadays, with variable fonts, you will notice libraries offering multiple variables rather than traditional styles, as they are easier to modify. So our final list is 13 fonts, under the criteria specified at the top. I can sort the final list of my fonts by most popular or trending to focus on couple that I want to download and use. At any point, you can reset all the filters to start fresh. You can also use the search font box to search for a specific font by its name. Then single click on the font to see all its options. Change the font size using the slider on the right. You can type a longer text in the preview text box to see how it would look in different styles and sizes. If you select the type tester, you get even more options such as the custom colors and heading levels to view. Glyphs show you different styles and symbols of the typeface. Under About and License, you can discover intriguing details like the font's designer, the number of websites using it, and its popularity in various countries. I always find this information interesting. Let's say this is our winner. This is the font we want to download and use. Select the Get Font blue button in the top right. You will see two different options, Get Embedded Code or Download All. There are also some step-by-step instructions how to use these two files. In a nutshell, the embedded code is used on websites. You would copy the code in two different places. One part of it has to be added to the head of your HTML, and the other has to be included in your CSS file. Watch my next video with specific step-by-step instructions. The download files are designed to add the font to specific platforms, such as Canva or your Mac or PC. Additionally, you can integrate Google Fonts directly in other platforms like Google Docs. I will create separate videos explaining how to do each. Thanks so much for watching!